The Hillcrest School, Tacoma Park Station, Washington, D.C., May 17, 1909. During our visit to Nashville, I visited the Hillcrest School Farm, where Brethren Staines and Broilier are laboring to establish a training school for colored workers. This farm of 93 acres is about 6 miles from Nashville. The location is excellent. Here the students can be trained to erect buildings and to cultivate the land as a part of their education. At the same time, they can be given instruction in Bible knowledge and be fitted by general study of wisely selected books to know how to do the work to which they are called. As I saw the different parts of the farm, my heart was glad. The hill land is suitable for the buildings, for the orchard, and for pasture, and the level land will be highly appreciated when faithfully worked. A beginning has been made in the erection of cottages for students. They are plain and inexpensive, but comfortable and convenient. Many of these cottages are needed. One cottage that I visited had just been built with money given by Sister Marion Stoll Crawford. Those who are bearing the burden of this work should be encouraged and not hindered by words that would dishearten them or dampen the faith of those who have been helping them. My heart was filled with thanksgiving to God that a place has been provided here near Nashville where intelligent youth seeking to obtain an education that will fit them to help others can have the advantages offered by the Hillcrest School. The Lord is indeed moving the hearts of His people and leading them to aid in the establishment of training centers for the education of colored youth to labor among their own race. Hillcrest is a beautiful property and gives opportunity to provide for many to receive a training for service. Let us thank God for this and take courage. Brother Staines and his associates are engaged in a good work. I believe that the Lord has led them and will bless them in doing conscientiously that which they have undertaken. It is my prayer that the Lord will move upon the minds of His people to take hold of this work and help it forward. We must not let the criticism and unwise movements of some of the brethren dishearten the workers and hinder the work. As the Lord has led Brother Staines to take up this work, so others will be led in various places to help. Men in different parts of the field, as laborers together with God, will search out promising colored youth and encourage them to attend this school, and they will help in the providing of a suitable building with classrooms. When we were ready to return to Nashville, the teachers and students all gathered in the classrooms, and I said to them, "I am thankful that I have had the privilege of visiting this school. You should all appreciate it. Here you have high and low ground. You are to prepare the ground for the sowing of the seed, and in your efforts the blessing of the Lord will certainly be with you if you will walk humbly with God. Trust in Him who understands the situation. Then He can work with you in all your efforts, and you will see the salvation of God. You will have our prayers and our help as far as we can give it. Our interests will go with you, and the Lord will help you in making this effort, not merely because of the good that may be accomplished in this school, but because of the many others who need the experience you are having. The work you do here may result in the salvation of hundreds of souls. If you will follow on to know the Lord, you may know His goings forth are prepared as the morning, and the blessing of the Lord will rest on parents and children. There is one point that we must be careful to remember. It is this, that the students in this school will carry away with them what they see and hear here. They will follow the example you give them. I am deeply interested in the work that is being done here because special light has been given me regarding the neglect there has been to take up the work you are doing. I have specified in my writings what this work is. I have tried again and again to impress its importance on the minds of the people. I shall still talk of it wherever I go. You are not working alone. When you are tempted to become discouraged, remember this, angels of God are right around you. They will minister to the very earth, causing it to give forth its treasures. This is the instruction I am trying to give to our schools. I want them to understand what could be accomplished if we would work according to the will of the Lord. It is the Lord who has given the instruction. Let us follow His direction. After speaking these words of encouragement, we bowed in prayer, and the blessing of the Lord rested upon me, giving assurance and hope regarding this work so humbly begun. I there decided to give $100 to help in equipping the school, and I now present to our people an invitation to join me in giving the means necessary to its work. Let the teachers consider this message, "Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness." Signed, Ellen G. White.